Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to this new episode of Swift Quiz, where this time we're going to be talking about dictionaries. So let's get started and take a look at the code. I've defined a dictionary that uses integer for keys and optional strings for values, and then I've initialized it with some keys and values. And just after initializing this dictionary, I've been updating its content. So on line 5, I've been setting the value nil for the key Q, and on line 6, I've been seemingly doing the same thing because I've been updating the value with nil for the key Q. And of course, the question I want to ask you is, what is the difference, if any, between lines 5 and 6? So what do you think? Do you think there's actually a difference between the code at line 5 and the code at line 6? Or do you think that these two syntaxes are just two different ways of writing the same thing? So let's find out what's the answer. First, I'm going to comment the code on line 6, and then I'm going to display the content of the dictionary after line 5 has been executed. And as you can see, after line 5 has been executed, there are now only two pairs of keys and values in my dictionary. There is this pair right here and this pair right there, but the last pair, so the one associated with the key Q, has been removed from the dictionary. So it seems whenever we use this subscript operator to set nil, it actually removes the key and value from the dictionary. Now let me comment the code at line 5 and uncomment the one at line 6. I'm going to run the code once more and we're going to see if there is a difference. And as you can see, there is indeed a difference because with the code at line 6, so the code where I call the method update value for key, I still have my three pairs of keys and values in my dictionary. And we can see that for the key Q, the value has been updated with the value nil. And so there was indeed a big difference between the code at line 5 and the code at line 6. Whenever we use the subscript operator to set nil to a given key in a dictionary, it actually removes both the key and the value from the dictionary. But on the other hand, when we call the method update value, even if we pass in a nil value for the value, it will not remove the key and the value. It will simply set nil for the given key. And so if you ever need to actually set a nil value inside a dictionary, make sure to use the method update value for key, because if you use the more familiar syntax of using a subscript, you will actually not be setting a nil value, but you will be removing the key from the dictionary. That's all for this episode of Swift Quiz. I hope you've enjoyed it. Thanks for watching it and see you next time.